I mean, it's something about a fresh line. Make a man feel like a million bucks. Fresh fade, get the tape or the shadow on it. Them waves so deep, you need a paddle for them. I mean, it's more than just hair. It's the confidence you feeling when you step up out that chair. And I swear, they tell me every bob is mean. From Trav Herm, B to Saeed, now say hello to the team. Cause the style supreme, my nigga, don't forget the style supreme. They know the style supreme, supreme style. Keep the whole town clean. Get a can of that sheen. Spray it on me, make me feel like a king.
Like a king.
That's what I mean by gold dreams. And they gon' get up on this smooth shit one day,
one day, one day, one day.
And you could even bang this cut on a Sunday, Monday. A bunch of Blake Griffins with them clippers. A Chris Paul throwing lives to us all. It's more than a cut. You don't need no stitches for this.
Nah.
Walk around with your missus for this. They know it's squizzy, but we gon' say exquisite for this.
Squizzy.
Exquisite for this. Put your sons, put your pops, put your neighbors on it. That flavor on it, then finish it with a razor on it.
Because it's more than a cut, though. I swear it's more than a cut.
Now grab a mirror. Right after that, finish your touch. Get up out the chair, you know what's up. I mean, it's more than a cut, though.
In my day, the barber was a counselor. He was a fashion expert. He was a style coach, pimp, just general all-around hustler.
I said all them things a long time ago, but I say this here, I'm still pretty.
Good morning, peace, Abari Ghani, Hotep, what's happening, what's cracking, wa alaikum salam. You are watching the Supremely Faded podcast with the Supreme Style Barbers. I'm Brother Herman Muhammad. We got the Supreme Style Barbers in the building. Trav's up in chia.
What's up?
Saeed Naloye. I don't know where B at. B, I think B went to go boo boo. what's going on, Supreme Style Barbers? East on lockdown, Trav? What's going on?
I just got a text. East is on lockdown.
East is on lockdown.
Again.
Again.
God dang.
Everybody got guns, man. We're not going to talk about that today.
Everybody be cool.
Where'd B go?
I think he went to go grab some coffee.
Oh. Okay. Y'all coming to the room, coming to the room. We got some, we want to talk about something today.
Share this out, man.
We want to talk about something. Jay Burns is in the building. We want to talk about something that everybody's talking about. And we talked about it a little bit on previous shows, but we really haven't gone in depth. But we want to do things a little bit differently, on the Supremely Faded podcast, because we love black people. Mm-hmm. Right? We love black people. Yeah. We really can't, we don't really care too much for niggas, but we love black people.
Facts.
And there's some nigga-ish going on around here.
Boy, is it.
Shanda's in the building. Hey, Shando.
Talk about the nigga-ish, boss.
It's Miss Stephanie Bush Caldwell's in the building. Hey, Stephanie.
What up, Steph?
We want to talk about the Holly. And the reason why we want to talk about the Holly is because something took place. Well, for those of you who don't know, let's tell you what the Holly is. The Holly is a book and a movie which centers around our brother from the great city of Denver, Brother Terrence Roberts, T-Rob the Realist. And, you know, it chronicles, it talks about a lot. But the main point of the movie really is surrounded around Terrence, his activism, his former gang affiliation, and the shooting that took place at a peace rally that he and other community activists were putting on a few years back. And we all saw the holly, right? All the Supreme Barbers, yes. Supreme Style Barbers saw the hollies. So we didn't read the book. I didn't read the book. Full disclosure. Did y'all read the book?
I didn't read the book.
No. Nobody read the book, but we all saw the movie. Mm-hmm. And this past Saturday, Brother Jeff and a few others had a meeting at the Hope Center where they were talking about the holly. And I didn't really like the whole conversation. But before we get into that, Trav, what did you think of the holly?
I thought it was a good movie. A little documentary. I thought it was good, you know. I think that they should have did some fact checking first before they did it. And it was really like one person's story and his beliefs. So to put it out as nonfiction,
right?
You know, and then that's why the you know, everybody's saying that.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It was fictional.
You good?
Four tires.
Oh yep. You can bring my man. Thanks, appreciate you, bro.
Look, her ordering tires and shit.
And then we're doing this podcast in real time. Right. I'm sorry, go ahead, Trav, go ahead.
Right, I think, well, you know, like, who knows the true stories, like, a lot of people are saying, like, a lot of those is lies, and the way the movie was set up was, it made people to believe something was happening that wasn't happening.
Right.
So, I think that everybody in the, usually when they make like something like that, a documentary or a movie or something, everybody gets paid.
Right.
So I mean, like the star of the documentary didn't get paid.
Yeah, this is I'm saying, right?
That shit about to roll on Koufax.
Right.
They're saying that the main guy in the documentary, who the documentary is about, didn't get paid, didn't get a dime. So I don't know.
They're saying Terrence didn't get paid?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Saeed, you saw the documentary. Mm-hmm. What were your thoughts?
I thought the documentary was put together pretty well. I think if you're going to do a story.
Thanks, bro. Appreciate you, man.
Thank you. If you're going to document some true events, I think that there needs to be all of the people in question need to be interviewed, you know. It was biased. I wish that, you know, that, what's his name, Julian Rubinstein. Who wrote the book, you know, it focused more so on Terrence, which it surrounds Terrence. But if you want to give a balanced look of the situation, why not interview everyone that, you know, you're speaking of?
Right.
To allow people to give their two on that and allow the audience to draw their own conclusion.
Right.
And it was very leading, it was very misleading. In some ways, I thought it was filmed very well. I thought it was, you know.
Yeah.
I thought it opened up some new questions that I had, you know, kind of about Terrence, you know, kind of answered some stuff for me. But I didn't like how what it's doing to the city right now.
Right, that part. Oh, you saw the Holly. What'd you think?
I mean, I thought it was pretty cool. You know what I'm saying? I didn't know a lot of the stuff that was going on in it, you know? But I thought it was all right. I thought it was pretty cool. I do feel like it was one-sided, though, like they saw.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, overall, I thought it was all right. Directed pretty good. Good film.
You know what? I agree with you guys, man. I think it was very, the movie was very well done.
It was.
Doc was very well done. It was certainly one-sided. And that's to be expected, you know what I mean? Like most, if a story is about a certain person, it's gonna lean towards them. You know what I'm saying? So that's to be expected. Here's the reason why I wanted to talk about the Doc, because of course I did not read the book. But I'm in agreement with Trav that the characterization of the Holly was over-dramatized. I grew up in Denver. Trav grew up in Denver. We all grew up here. You know, Saeed grew up in Colorado Springs, but Denver, you know what I'm saying? He's been down here for the majority of his life. The Holly's never been a place that I feared to go.
Right.
You know what I mean? I never worried about being in fear of my life. I never worried about, even though there is gang banging, it's not confined to the Holly. But I think the documentary, along with the thing that National Geographic did, that Terrence was also a part of as well, really demonized and over-dramatized the so-called gang activity that takes place in Denver, specifically in the Holly.
Right.
And so that's one what I find problematic. But the other thing that I find problematic is what Brother Saeed was saying in terms of what this is doing to the city. Because full transparency, you know, we don't have no beef with Terrence Roberts. Love Terrence Roberts.
Yeah.
We ain't got no beef with P-Lo. Love P-Lo. Love Carl McKay with the middle school with Carl McKay. You know what I mean? That's my guy. Reverend Kelly, Brother Jeff, of course. You know, I've known Brother Jeff forever. You know, so none of the players in this whole drama do we have a problem with. But it seems to me that Terrence Roberts being an anti-gang activist, Carl McKay now being an anti-gang activist, all of these people being anti-gang activists, now it seems, no, it doesn't seem, they are. They straight gangbanging over this documentary.
Right now.
Right now.
This is the new set. The new set trip.
So, like I said, I don't have no issues. What they saying in the chat room? Jay said, I felt like it was the white man yet again exploiting the black man's anger in order to divide the community and to monetize. Look at Jay Burns on it. Okay, Jay, we get right to that. Michelle said it's pretty decisive right now, divisive, I think she's trying to say right now. Do y'all feel the movie will help or hurt his campaign for Denver mayor? That's Chris Quick asked that.
It didn't matter. Like, people know who he is.
Right.
But I feel like that forum that was held Saturday hurt his campaign.
Right. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Because that was showing his character. Then when you put somebody up as a liar, you know what I mean? You put him up as a liar and people, I think a lot of people don't understand, like, if you say Carl McKay works with the police,
right,
you're a snitch,
mm-hmm,
then you gotta say everybody that does the work for the gang activity.
Go into that, Trav.
They all work for the police.
Build on that.
Anybody has a nonprofit, to get that money of gang activity, you have to talk to the police.
Right.
You have to tell them who is who and what is what's going on.
That's right.
Reverend Kelly did it.
That's right.
Everybody does it. Like
you have to. It's so harder at work.
He's a snitch.
Then you put the target on his back.
You put the target on his back.
Right.
By putting the paperwork up when all of y'all talk to that Commander Keller.
This is what this is.
All y'all been under his umbrella.
Nonprofit.
Right.
That's what the nonprofit's about.
That's what you have to do that in order to get that status of being.
So if that snitched, then everybody did it.
Yeah.
You can't just say this one person out of that whole lineup did that. Like
I agree.
You can't do that.
I agree. But here's the greater point, and Jay makes it, and we've been talking about it in the barbershop. And this is why the reason for the show. That debacle that they had on Saturday night was freaking ridiculous. And it's just another example of some outsider coming in the community. Like, okay, let's talk about it. Because let's call it spade a spade. This cat, Julian Rubinstein, I hope I'm saying his name right. He's a writer. He wrote some other
one other book
that I saw in his little biography. He's wrote a number of articles for he used to write for some sports magazines. He's wrote for Rolling Stone. He's a fairly well-known author in those circles. But and at one point, I'm reading in his bio, he was he used to live in Denver. He was raised in Denver as a kid. He's born in New York, raised in Denver for a while. But he sees a story in the New York Post or the New York Times, one of the two, about the Terrence Roberts situation and decides to come here and create a story. And that's essentially what is going on, because the Holly, the movie that he came up with, the book that he came up with, is not necessarily the truth. According to everyone, except for Terrence, it's not necessarily the truth. And I didn't see it really as true because I've never seen the Holly in that light. You know what I mean? But he creates this narrative to where now Black people in the community leaders, are fighting one another.
Yep. I'm gonna say this, man.
Say it loud so we can hear you.
This is what the fuck white people do, man. They've been doing it and they continue to do this. They will find two groups of Black people and pit them one another,
right,
them against one another. Not caring about the carnage that is left behind in the communities that are done.
Right.
You know, our brother Carl, man, look, he got his whole image is tainted right now. Whether he's good, bad, or indifferent, I don't know. I wouldn't want that on my back.
Right.
Even when you go back in history and you study white people, this is what they do.
Right.
Even when we was in so-called Africa, they would pit tribes against one another,
yes,
and they
sir
would wiggle their way in. Divide and conquer.
That's real.
We're still falling for that. It's 2023, you would think Black people would know better by now.
That's real. That's real.
Yeah, you're right. My thing about that whole thing is, a lot of people don't see it as being like and put somebody in danger, because like now, like Carl's not gangbanging now, okay? But if you put that jacket on somebody,
right?
When he was in the streets, he knew all the secrets.
Right.
He knew who did what, who did this, who did that. So when those people look and they say, "Oh my God, he's doing that," I got to get rid of him. Because he knows all my secrets. People don't look at it like that. They're not looking at it. And that's what I said, like, when you label somebody that, like, you've been working with the
right
police, and these people are on the side. They done ran with him and did things with him that, you know, they shouldn't have done as children.
Right.
So now you've grown, you're like, man.
Trev, who was the brother at the hearing on Saturday? that said that he wanted to put harm on Terrence. What's the brother's name?
Oh, that was Pilo.
Pilo. Did they have a beef before this situation happened?
No, not really. No, because remember, it started when Terrence was down here with the news reporter, and he was doing a story on how Pilo rolled up on him. That was after the fact.
Terrence shot Munch, and people don't understand, Munch is Ice's son. Okay. So what did Pilo say? What did he say in the thing? What did he say before he stormed up out of it? He said he's gonna whoop his ass. And where the white boy at?
The white boy is in the chat room.
He's in the chat room.
The white boy is in the chat room. While the black people are talking and fighting amongst one another. They're talking stuff about Terrence, and the white boy is in the chat
talking shit about
the black leadership. Julian Rubinstein, let's say his name.
Where he come from, man?
Get his name. Because here's the thing, we have to understand that this thing is bigger than what it appears.
Right.
Because, again, they turned the Holly into something that it wasn't. Using a story, using a narrative.
Yeah.
And now, the documentary, the movie, it's not a local thing. It won all sorts of... The most accolades that Julian Rubinstein has gotten has been for The Holly. And it went from being awarded locally to now it's being awarded nationally and internationally. It premiered in New York. Now here's the dude to Saeed's point. Besides The Holly, he got one other book. You know what I mean? But now you're getting national accolades for a story, a narrative that's written really off of the suffering, the trauma, the infighting of people in the black community.
So he's doing the same thing 50 Cent is doing with these shows that he's putting out, showing the division of black people, but he's just going in the world of literature to keep.
But there's a difference to crowbar his success.
There's a difference between 50 Cent. 50 Cent wrote his shit.
Right.
50 Cent is the owner of his shit.
Exactly. And 50 Cent.
And he's getting paid. He's the first black
and
person.
50, a member of the community. See, this is my biggest problem. Like, okay, you gonna write a story about
You put the book out.
You put the book out. If you gonna write a story, Terrence, you know what I'm saying? But don't have this dude who's not from the community come into the black community and now he's profiting off of our story. Like, can you imagine going up to, we talking about 33rd and Holly. Can you imagine going to Alameda and Holly or 1st and Holly or 6th and Holly in the Jewish community and you get going into one of their community services and writing the story and then selling it?
You know why? Because they on call with each other. They not gonna do that.
That part.
They would never do that. That's like Ruben write the Supreme Style story. You know. And like, what did Herman? What's wrong with Herman?
I mean, we could even take it from Ruben, because he was the least part of the shot. You know what I mean? This dude.
No, I'm talking about you. I'm talking about Ruben.
Oh, Ruben. Yeah. Sure. Like, that's what I'm saying. I go to Cherry Creek, and I get to write a story on what's going on in Cherry Creek.
Can't do that. Talking about somebody that went to jail and then how it affected this community. And
come on, man. See, that's crazy, man.
It's kind of like all of us sitting up here, and none of us watched the documentary, and we talking about it. Now, look, like I said before, the documentary was put together very well. It kept my attention. It gave me a whole nother insight on Terrence. You know, like, okay, I see where he's coming from with this. But then at the end of the day, like, why was this put out? What is this about?
Right. But you know, there's a lesson, man, in the nation, man. And you talked about that. There's a question, why do we Run Yakub and his maid dealt with from the root of civilization because he started telling lies amongst the original people, causing them to fight and kill one another. And this is exactly what this dude is doing. He's telling lies because the documentary wasn't all true. And if something is not all true, then that means it has lies in it. And the way that they shaped the narrative, the way that they made the Hollywood, the way the timeline, when even when Terrence shot Lil Munch, you know what I'm saying? The way that the Bloods allegedly came out before, but when in truth they came out after. You know what I mean? That whole timeline was a lie. When we was at the community meeting, that Saeed's in the movie, Saeed's in the Hollywood. He didn't get no money either.
Saeed's in the
But Terrence came in with Rubinstein.
Yeah.
And with cameras rolling. And Terrence, like to Brother Jeff's point, hadn't been in the community for a while because of the shooting. So it's like, but they were shaping and forming a narrative.
In the documentary.
To say.
Making it look like it was about Terrence.
Exactly.
But, okay, so I'm going to say this. If I did a documentary on me, I'm going to put the 24s on that.
You have to.
I'm going to put the 24s on this bitch to make myself look nice, man.
But at that same time, man, you got to have some balance with that, though. Just like with this whole thing this weekend. Mm-hmm. If we're going to put together a forum of people who are going to talk about the Hollywood, although I heard that Terrence was invited, but didn't show up, why would he show up anyway? If he's running for mayor,
he can't show up.
He can't show up because the potential of what may have what happened.
Exactly.
But if you're trying to heal people, wait till after the election's over and then invite Terrence to come and speak for himself to where we can have a healing process about this whole thing. Right now, the community is divided. So I want to ask, how many black people are in the mayoral campaign, the race?
How many black people are in the mayoral campaign? You got like Terrence, of course. You got
maybe two, three.
Leslie Hare. You got Al Gardner. You got Lisa Calderon.
Four.
So
the way that this was looking, I mean, people can say like Terrence didn't have a chance, but when you watch those little debates, he sound real good.
Right.
He's crunching numbers. He's saying what he's supposed to say. He's looking political.
Right.
And I think a lot of people did not like that. Like, the timing is everything.
Mm-hmm.
So the timing of that forum, to me, was, that was the whole Terrence Roberts bashing.
Yeah, and look at the result of it, because now you have people looking at Terrence like he's a
liar.
He's a liar. He's a killer. He's a gangster. He's not Terrence Roberts anymore. He's showbiz. Based off what we just saw on Saturday. Even if he had a chance in some people's minds, now that has been destroyed.
Yeah, exactly.
And it's all rooted. You know what I'm saying? Because like I said, I'm not blaming black people. I'm blaming us for falling for the okey-doke again. But it's all rooted in what this Julian Rubinstein has written and showed as a movie. And form the narrative. Because Terrence, I mean, I can't believe he's not getting paid.
I can't believe that either.
He gotta be getting paid. If it's your story, you gotta be getting paid, right?
We gotta fact check that though. I mean, he got to be getting some money off of that.
Right.
Right.
Mm-mm-mm. Well, we shall see.
How can we fact check? I don't know. Ask him. Take his bank
account. Hey, man. You gotta ask him, man. We gotta call Terrence up and ask him. Brother, you getting paid, brother.
So I don't know, man. It's
so Nichelle writes, another movie director seeking notoriety by the continued romanticizing of black struggle and violence for profit. One person tweeted about his movie saying, "The Holly connects the dots between Denver's history of gang violence, real estate development, and law enforcement practices. When natives know the Holly wasn't solely the reason why we have those issues." And that's absolutely right. That's absolutely right. He created a story. He created a narrative. Like, for real?
Right.
We gotta wake up. We gotta keep these demons up out of our community.
Leon Kelly, excuse me. I'm sorry.
Go ahead. You here?
He definitely got to go. Number
one. We're not doing that though. We're not doing that though. We're not talking about black people at all. We all have issues. You know what I mean? And we all have issues with all of the players who are involved in this entire drama, right? We all do. Don't none of us agree 100%. Black people are monolithic. You know what I'm saying? We're gonna have a problem with what this one does, what that one does. However, if we got a problem, we're gonna say, if I got a problem with Terrence, I'm gonna call Terrence up and be like, hey Terrence, hey T, I got a problem, bro. If I got a problem with Leon Kelly, I'm gonna call him up. Hey Red, we gotta chop this up. You know what I'm saying? Any of the players involved, that's what we gonna do because we on code. But what we cannot do is air our dirty laundry out for white folks entertainment. And white folks and that's all in the chat. They all in the chat, man. Rubinstein, all in the chat. You know what I'm saying? Profiting off of our suffering, our trauma. I mean, people are dying, man.
Yeah.
And this dude cut short with a camera.
Yeah.
Think about that.
That's him.
He show up with a camera. This devil shows up with a camera and a story. And now he's getting accolades. Like Kelly was saying, acclimates. He getting accolades and money and movie premieres and awards and all this stuff. For filming our trauma. I'm good. that's the most important piece, man. That's the most important piece. We gotta keep these types of people out of our community.
And how we keep them out of the community is having a proper knowledge of self and of history.
Right.
When they start coming, we already know what time it is. Like, no, sir, you're not doing this. We have our own writers. We have our own minds that can put this our story together.
Right,
yes,
right,
sir.
Hey, B. Hey, man. So Toya said, Terrence has always had the gift of gab and some sense of intelligence. He may get money on the back end of the projects. Don't know. Sister Yolanda, the co-hostess with the most, said every time, but some black people want to continue to put their trust into the white devil. Woo!
Yolanda said that?
Yolanda said that. Oh, there was some more commentary. She said that's what white people don't do. They don't. They won't air their dirty laundry, but we black people let them come in our community and air ours. I agree. 1,000%.
Exactly.
1,000%.
Andre Brown in the house. Crenshaw.
Crenshaw in the building. Look, man, this is the enemy right here. It's not Terrence. It's not Red. It's not Brother Jeff. Not none of them.
No.
This is him. This is your enemy. This is the dude who's profiting off of your trauma, your suffering, gang violence. He's weaving a narrative. I mean, beautiful, colorful Colorado is now gang territory? Like, really?
Right. You make me scared to go over there?
Come on, man.
Ain't nobody over in the motherfucking Holly.
In the Holly.
You got a nice little gym over there that's still there, high water. And you got a boys and girls club right there. Yeah. Ain't nobody hanging out in the Holly.
You know what I'm saying? We gonna paint it like it's the south side of Chicago or something. Come on, man.
No, it's nice over there. Restaurant.
Or Compton.
Go down to Fuller Park and do it.
Come on, no, man.
You might have a little
movie. We'll have a
look, man, you can get into some trouble anywhere. You can get there's gang stuff everywhere. They call it Aurora A code. You know what I mean? If you're talking to the right or the wrong people, you can go to Colfax and Yosemite and get busted.
Colfax and anything. Colfax and anything. Get your ass.
So there's pockets, you know what I mean, of violence and gang activity, man, all over America, man. But don't do that. Come on, man. Die.
And it's the time, man, with black folks, man. We don't need to be, you know, divided right now. We need to really unify.
Right.
If we got some issues, we need to go behind closed doors, man. We don't need to have this on blast talking about our brothers. You know, they did this. Well, I'm going to whoop his ass. And blah, 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 blah. No, man. We going to have it. Let's take it inside, man. It's family business.
Right.
It's family business, man. Get white folks out our business.
Get them out your business. We don't recognize who they are yet. That's incredible. That's incredible. He got to be getting some money. He got to be getting some money.
Got to get some money, man. I don't want no harm on none of these brothers involved in this, man. And I know they're angry right now, man. But shit, we got to figure out who behind all this.
Exactly. Exactly.
But do y'all think the movie would have gotten the push that it got if it was Terrence Roberts?
No.
You know what? No.
Because Terrence Roberts don't have no Hollywood connections.
His name's not.
Only Julian Rubinstein got them Hollywood connections. That's his brother who run that.
And people love to see blacks suffering, so let's give us a... Denver's uncharted territory. Let's talk about Denver. We didn't heard the Chicago,
right.
The New York,
right.
The L.A. Let's go to Denver now and see.
You know what's interesting, man, is people come in every day from different parts of the country, and they'll find a barbershop, and they like a brother told me yesterday, he's from Chicago.
Yeah.
I didn't even know they had black barbershops in Denver.
Right.
So he don't even know. He's like amazed that we got black people. And here this dude is writing the narrative that not only do we have black people, but we like the gang capital of the Mountain West. Come on, man. Man, stop letting these people tell our stories.
Dre said they kill him in the roar and the hood is safe. That's true.
You know what's interesting, Dre? Like, my whole perspective, you know, I'm a native just like all y'all. Born and raised in Denver. When people ask me where the hood at, I'm like, Denver don't have a hood. Denver does not have a hood. I mean, when we talk about the Holly, you got a couple little apartment complexes around here, but for the most part, everybody got a house, they got lawns, they go to work. Like, the hood, I mean, the Curtis Park project, okay.
Wait, I'm gonna cut you off. The shooting was at East. Two people got shot. Two adults got shot.
Wow.
Rewrote the show just said Rubenstein just tweeted about East. He called out Mayor Hancock saying he supported gang members running anti-gang programs. He just did this.
He tweeted about East?
Yeah.
And what did he say?
Read it. Michelle just put him in.
What?
My point.
Come on, man.
Breaking news.
My point.
All up in it.
Okay.
Let's make my point.
Michelle, thank you so very much. Julian Rubinstein just tweeted about East. He called out Mayor Hancock saying he supported gang members running anti-gang programs. He just did this. Wow.
So let's go ahead and
come on, man. Y'all don't know who the devil is? Who the enemy is right in front of your face? Got us fighting and killing one another. Now he's criticizing the mayor. He can't do that. He don't get to do that. We can criticize the mayor. But he can't.
Who was you?
Right. He's not even from Denver. He's from New York.
Right. Mayor Hancock, get at us, man.
I hope you got a white boy saying support mayor members running.
Get at us. Mayor Hancock.
Man, y'all better get these white people out of your business, man.
Get at us.
Come on, man. Wow. Unbelievable.
Yeah,
this is crazy, man. I'm here. Yolanda said, the co-host with the most said, black people are quick to trust the white man, then want to get mad at black folks because of their misguided trust. Yeah.
Yeah.
He's speaking loudly against anti-Semitism. Okay, this is Michelle. He used black people as a stage to introduce his platform. He's speaking loudly against anti-Semitism. So my thing, going to the Jewish community with your camera. Yeah, and you know, they use that so-called anti-Semitism as a trick to
shut you up.
Stop exactly.
You.
Shut
stop
you up.
If you tell him the truth.
But he ain't even no Semite.
No, he ain't even no Semite.
So-called Jew. Yeah, I said it.
He's a Kazar.
For real. Yahoo. For
see,
real.
There's a lot of things that they do right in front of us that we don't even realize. How they okay, so say for instance the NFL.
Right.
So all these black quarterbacks, they put their whatever their contract is, they put the whole thing, they disclose the whole thing. We have never known how much money Tom Brady made.
Right.
Never known a Peyton Manning contract.
True that.
They say Peyton Manning took a pay cut to get other players in. But how much was this motherfucker making?
Exactly.
We don't know that. But then when you got Russell Wilson, $250 million, so that makes, and he had poor performance, and everybody goes at Russell Wilson. He's not worth that money.
Right.
That's what they say. But then when Brady or Aaron Rodgers have a bad season, they don't say he's not worth that money because they don't know how much money he makes.
That's exactly right.
He's making the same amount. They're probably making more.
Travis, they stay on code. They stay on code. They protect their own.
Lamar Jackson. Oh, he's a dumb man. He turned down $150 million.
It's just like,
why? How do y'all, why y'all putting all his business out there, all the money that he's making? Y'all never put none of them quarterbacks, elite quarterbacks. We've been here, I've been here my whole life. I've never known how much money John Elway made.
You're not going to know.
In his career, I never knew how much money, I never knew one contract that John Elway had.
Just like we're not going to know how much money Rubinstein is making off this documentary.
Exactly. That's to say that.
You know what I'm saying? His name all on it. It's all about Terrence, but his name is all on it. It's authorship, meaning he getting all the money.
Now you got a thing out with Terrence for free.
Terrence now risking his life. You know what I mean? Because of the atmosphere that was created from the movie and from the book.
And he got to live here.
He got to live here. You get to go back to New York. Tweet some stuff about the black community, and don't nobody check you on it. Come on, man. No.
Yolanda said Kanye was telling the truth.
Kanye was absolutely telling the truth.
He was.
1,000%.
See, that's the thing. Y'all canceling, and then make these businesses canceling, and these businesses go under. Adidas about to go fucking under. They had to go back and get Kanye.
Right.
So why aren't they putting that big shit in the news? Put that back in the news.
They don't want to put that back.
Because they come back.
Here comes some anti-Semitism because they control the media.
Yeah.
And they're not going to tell that story.
Put that story back.
So if Kanye the true Semite, who the real anti-Semite?
Exactly. It's just like this whole story with the Holly. It's big news. It's all over the internet. Like I said, this dude is running all sorts of accolades because his brother, Rubenstein's brother controls the media, so he'll push his brother's stuff out there.
Collins said that he got $400,000 to start it, but we don't know what he's receiving now. Who there, Rubenstein College?
Yeah, who received $400,000? We got to fact check that. But yeah, man, we got an open enemy. Here he is again. I'm going to keep showing this picture so y'all know. This picture,
yeah,
his
name.
Oh, Rubinstein got $400,000. Yeah, easy.
So, you know, he done made that back with Amazon.
That's amazing. Because remember, it started on Amazon, like you said.
Then stars for free.
Then stars for free. So now you got major distribution.
Stars pick you up.
Come on, man. When's the major motion picture coming? Because you know that's next.
Yeah, starring Michael B. Jordan. That's Terrence Roberts. Chrome will be in that.
Criminal gang members running around, running out youth, anti-virus program.
You know,
I haven't heard the news say it was a gang thing. It just started. It just happened.
He gets to say whatever he wants to say.
When I pulled up, it was only 5 minutes into it.
Why does he get to say that? Because he's anti-Semitic himself.
Mm-hmm. He's anti-black.
Mm-hmm. But we the true Semites.
He's a white supremacist. That's exactly what he is. I'm going to say it publicly. Julian Rubinstein, the author of
Confusion.
The Holly and Confusion, is a white supremacist.
I want to see him come in and say the comments.
He's a white supremacist, so-called Jew.
Everybody on this,
who's running game on the black community here in Denver, Colorado.
Uh-huh.
Wake up, black people. Don't fall for the okie doke.
We should have no more discussions on what Julian Rubinstein has wrote.
Exactly. Don't feed into it. Don't have no forums. Don't get to fighting with your brother while the devil is in the chat room dissing your leadership. Come on, man. Don't do that. He literally in the chat room.
Yeah. Going hard. He was going hard in there. Somebody told him, hey, man, you done went at three of our community leaders. Hey. You need to shut up. But he's saying that, and that don't sound like somebody that's scared.
Right.
He's saying that he fears for his life.
Yeah, he's saying that his life is like threat.
So you in there talking shit to everybody. You're not scared. If you're scared, you're going to shut up. You're going to stay away from that avenue.
That's exactly right. That's exactly right.
Yeah, you ain't going to get on that block. Oh, shit. I'm scared. But, you know, to sum it up, the whole thing, it was good TV. You know what I mean? It was
yeah.
Good TV.
Yeah, it's good entertainment, man.
It's good entertainment.
For white folks.
But
you suffering.
People hear that's
yeah.
The truth. You can't do that. You can't, you know what I'm saying? Like, you can't put. My whole thing about coming out the whole thing is Carl. You can't put this man's life in danger like
right.
That. Right. You know what I'm saying? You can't do that because. If you pull out everybody that runs a non-profit program steered towards the kids, they all got it.
Right.
They all in Calo's paperwork. They all in that paperwork.
Right on their
hands. They all report to the police officer.
You have to in order to receive those funds.
You have to keep the funds.
To be that anti-gang
activist. You can't just be rolling around like not doing nothing.
You gotta work in
concert with the
police. You gotta
turn some kids in.
That's just what it is.
You gotta turn some in. You gotta say, hey, I heard this. This what happened.
You have to. That's part of the work.
That's part of the work. I'm telling you, it's not. I mean, at that point, that's your job.
Right.
So now it's not snitching. Like, you're not in the gang no more.
And see, that's the thing, man. People need to redefine what snitching is. Snitching is we both involved in some wrong. I get caught, but in order to save my ass, I tell on you. That's snitching.
Right. So what's up?
But if you're an anti-gang activist, right? If you're an anti-gang activist,
write a damn book.
You gotta work with the police. You gotta work with different organizations. You're trying to stop this gang activity from going on. That's not snitching.
Right.
You doing what you said that you was gonna do.
Right. Hey,
come on, man.
When we was younger and we got pulled over and we knew like some of the cops that was cool, we would say like Crystal's uncle, I can't remember his name, but we would ask for him.
And they're like, oh, you know him? And you'd be like, yeah. And be like,
oh, I knew him.
All right, well, y'all go ahead. Get out of here. Don't do that again. Come on, man.
Right.
So now I get pulled over. I say, hey, can you call Officer Perry, man? Oh, you know Officer Perry? How you know Officer Perry? Y'all, he's my guy, man. That's
right.
You know, he's married to my friend's mom. Oh, okay. Well, here. Hey, slow down, man. Have a good day. It's simple. That didn't make me a snitch. I mean, somebody paperwork.
There's no new family.
Come on, man.
And so the white boy come in, write a book off of our division.
Yeah, that's it.
For my nigga, get paid off of our division, off of some shit that can be settled in house. And he's just gonna fan the flames on something else, make matters way worse than what it need to be.
That's what they do. Michelle put a post, very powerful post. She said, very simple. Black trauma equals Hollywood dollars.
Mm-hmm. All day long. From slave movies to gang movies.
And, yeah. And Dre said, doing the monkey for the honky.
Good job.
That's old school. The honky.
Hey, Dre, did you type that in the Kenyo? Kenyo's a hard one. Kenyo's a honky every day.
We need to go hard on them, though, because they've been going hard on us forever. You better go hard on them. Right. That's the only thing they understand. Don't even be, you can't even bring your ass to Park Hill, Julian Rubinstein. That's how it should be, because you can't go up in that community. They checking you at the gate.
What are you doing?
What are you doing here? What's your business here? Who are you visiting?
The police will pull you over. Pull in that neighborhood and ride around.
See, yeah, man. You getting jammed. It's a jam session.
I'm telling you. What are you doing over here?
Exactly.
Get lost. Go over there and fake get lost.
Real talk.
Have an 8 police cars on.
Real talk.
What are you doing? Are you stealing? Right. Trying to break these houses?
Right. Tell me. So we're talking about Julian Rubinstein. We're talking about the movie and the book, The Holly. We're talking about, most importantly, black people getting on code and running these demons from amongst us whenever we see them. Mm-hmm. Don't come in our community and say nothing. Don't come in asking no questions. Don't be trying to do no stories. Let's write our own stories. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Let's get on this. We are the inventors.
Right.
Got plenty of talented writers here in this city. Everybody got a book out right now.
You know, it's interesting, man, because conquerors always write the history.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? And that's the reason why we don't have none in this country. It's because we've been conquered. And so they wrote in the history books a paragraph worthly, y'all niggas were slaves. You see what I'm saying? So this same type of Julian Rubinstein, man, he's that dude, man, writing the history, mischaracterizing our neighborhood, mischaracterizing our community, mischaracterizing black leadership, and then got nerve to tweet. Man, unbelievable. We better wake up.
Nicole, Lisa, Terrence is a thug. Terrence ain't no thug. Ain't no thug no more.
He's a humble young brother.
He's running for mayor, man. I want to see what he do without us tearing him down first.
Right. There's an African proverb that says, until the lion tells his side of the story, the tale of the hunt will always glorify the hunter.
That's right. Say that again.
Until the lion tells his side of the story, the tale of the hunt will always glorify the hunter.
Man.
That was nice. That was like we was just in church.
That's real. That's real. Mm-hmm. That's real. We need to redirect our attention, man, towards the real enemy. The real enemy is not us.
Right. For real. Nicole, you like the way your name is in that song?
Yeah.
That was funny. That was the highlight of my week.
Yeah, we didn't even talk about the whole gentrification piece on what this does to our neighborhoods.
Okay. Yeah.
Divide and conquer. But much space, man. Land grab.
But see, the whole gentrification piece, I have an issue with us having an issue with gentrification in the sense that.
Right,
you we're know, we the one who's selling.
Exactly. We the one who's exactly. doing it.
We the one who's selling.
That is true.
And so, if we're selling the property and they're moving us out to Green Valley Ranch and the Southeast Aurora, wherever we're moving, then what we should do is just let's control those communities. Let's control the businesses in those communities.
But what's happening now is the black people with the big dollars is coming in, buying, pushing us out.
Right.
Wellington is still owned by black people, believe it or not. But they pushed all the black businesses out of there.
Right. Hmm.
So is that...
including the cops.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Is that on us still? Because how you do
it's
that?
It's all on us.
Business, and this is our own business.
And that's the thing. We gotta control the businesses in our community or else we don't have community. You might have your home there, but you don't have no community if you don't run the businesses, if you don't run the schools,
right.
If the politicians don't listen to you. You don't have no community. You're just a colony.
Wall Street gone.
Everything gone, bro.
Everything gone. But it's, we did it.
That's real.
We did it. And we're going to continue to do it, you know.
That is real.
Money talks.
Huh? We can get to the other subject we're supposed to talk about on reparations.
It's over.
Oh, reparations.
One time. We're going to talk about reparations, though. We're going to do that next week.
$5 million.
We are. What y'all got to sell, man? We got 2 minutes, and we out of here. Come to...
Man, sell this to Rumors thing.
Real talk. Go to astar2.com, man, and schedule your appointment. Also, go to astar2.com/shop if you want our merch. We got hats, t-shirts, hoodies, the whole nine.
Support the final call newspaper.
Happy Black Dollar Days? Yeah, every day is Supreme Style.
Black Dollar Days.
What happened? That's every day.
We're selling stuff right now. Yeah, Black Dollar Days, come on in here.
Final Call newspaper, come and pick that up here or go to finalcalldigital.com. Listen, man, we are getting out of here, but the lesson of today, man, run these devils out of your community. And let's take it back.
Unified.
And let's make it black. All day, day.
Let's love on each other and push each other forward, man.
That's it.
Settle your differences responsibly.
That's it. Love. I see my mechanic looking for me, so we're going to get out of here.
The doers do.
Right. Get you some insurance. We out. We'll see y'all next time. Peace.
I just wanted to drop in and let you know what we have going on. In addition to our community work that we've been doing for years, and in addition to being the sole proprietor of Supreme Style Barbershop, where we've been serving the community for close to 25 years, now we've partnered up with an insurance company called Ethos in an effort to help our people with life insurance. That's something that we all need. I know it's something that we don't want to think about, but it is something that we all need if we want to leave anything to our loved ones when we leave this space. So do me a favor, click on the link or go to our website, astar2.com, and click on the Ethos page. We'll see you on the other side.